19th Sunday in Ordinary Time, Vienni Sunday. When will our churches be opened so that we can come together as the body of Christ to receive the bread of life? This is a question that is uppermost in the minds of many. People are longing to taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Though there appears to be no end in sight to the ongoing pandemic, we continue our pilgrim journey in faith, walking together in love. We trust that the Lord will provide us with the resources necessary for our journey and lead us safely to His holy mountain. Today, as the Archdiocese celebrates Vienni Sunday, we pray that the Lord may continue to bless all priests through the intercession of the saintly cure of ours. May our priests find strength and inspiration to offer spiritual nourishment to the flock, even in these difficult times.
Mass intentions. For the intentions of the parishioners, soul of Hector Serps, soul of Francino and Petrolina Gomes, soul of Glad Gracious Tevor, soul of Ralph Bernard D'Souza, Thanksgiving Mass for all favors received, soul of Sebastine and Bernadette Gomes, soul of Ronald and Florence De Silva, soul of Alex and Mary De Silva. Kindly rise for the entrance hymn.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear sisters and brothers in Christ Jesus, today the Archdiocese of Bombay celebrates the Vianney Sunday. As we celebrate Vianney Sunday, let us pray for our own priests. Please pray for all the priests you know in your life. Pray for them so that God may bless all the priests. I would like you to pray for our team which is here in Don Bosco Parish. Pray also for the team which is in Bosco Boys Home, together with all the other fathers whom you know. I would like to pray for all of them and offer this Eucharist for all of you, so that from you some more new priests can come, and for all of us, those who are priests, I am offering this Mass so that the Christ may continue to inspire us to walk the journey which He has set for us as anointed priests. To prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault.
Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Sins of the world, receive.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, who made the priest Saint John Vianney wonderful in his pastoral zeal, grant, we pray, that through his intercession and example, we may in charity win brothers and sisters for Christ and attain with them eternal glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. In those days, Elijah went on a day's journey into the wilderness and came and sat down under a broom tree. And he asked that he might die, saying, "It is enough now, O Lord, take away my life, for I am no better than my fathers." And he lay down and slept under a broom tree. And behold, an angel touched him and said to him, "Arise and eat." And he looked, and behold, there was at his head a cake baked on hot stones and a jar of water. And he ate and drank and lay down again. And the angel of the Lord came again a second time and touched him and said, "Arise and eat, for the journey is too great for you." And he arose and ate and drank and went in the strength of that food 40 days and 40 nights to Horeb, the mount of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of Saint Paul to the Ephesians. Do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, by whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and slander be put away from you, along with all malice. Be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, as God in Christ forgave you. Therefore, be imitators of God as beloved children, and walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us, a fragrant offering and a sacrifice to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, the Jews grumbled about Jesus because he said, "I am the bread that came down from heaven." They said, "Is not this Jesus the son of Joseph, whose father and mother we knew? How does he now say, 'I have come down from heaven'?" Jesus answered them, "Do not grumble among yourselves. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up on the last day. It is written in the prophets, 'And they will all be taught by God.' Everyone who has heard and learned from the Father comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father, except he who has come from him. He has seen the Father. Truly, truly, I say to you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your fathers ate the manna in the wilderness and they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that one may eat of it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. If anyone eats of this bread, he will live forever. And the bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear sisters and brothers in Christ Jesus, the first reading taken from the Book of Kings. There's a journey of Elijah in the wilderness. He walks 40 days and 40 nights to reach the mountain of the Lord. And this journey he has to make. And when you have a set journey to make, the Lord always intervenes. He was there with Elijah, where there was no food available, There was food for him and a jar of water to drink. Elijah drank that when the angel came to him and said, "Get up, you have a long journey, eat and drink." Once again he slept, again second time the angel came and then gave him food and water to drink. With that strength from God, we reach the mountain of God. In our lives too, if God gives us a work to do, God has a plan for all of us, definitely when we discover it, He walks the journey with us. He calls, He only gives us the strength, and we are at the mountain of the Lord. We are at His feet. This is how Elijah does. Even Saint John Mary Vianney, he had an inclination to become a priest. He was not good in studies. In fact, at the theology level, they told him, "We will send him back home." But his bishop intervened that every time I met Mary Vianney, Saint John Mary Vianney, he was always prayerful. He is very simple. Let us, because of his devotion to Mother Mary, let us make him a priest. And he was ordained a priest. Lord wanted him to be a priest, and he set up people, gave inspiration so that he will be made a priest. The second reading, Ephesians, it's very beautiful. Chapter 4, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, please read the chapter 4 by yourself today, full chapter of Ephesians chapter 4. The letter to the Ephesians, very, very beautiful. There where he gives, Saint Paul is giving all of us rules for new life. And what are the rules for new life? No more lying. We don't have to lie. We have to speak the truth. And only in the truth we discover peace and harmony within our families and also within our religious communities. Whatever happens, truth, no more lying. This is what the Ephesians tells us. Rules for new life. Second, the anger. The anger must not lead us to sin. And also the anger must not remain. By the end of the day, when the sun is going down, everyone has to make reconciliation within the family for that day and also within our religious communities with priests, fathers, brothers, sisters, so that our life becomes very meaningful. We ask forgiveness from the Lord. That is no more lying, and this anger we have to deal. And in this chapter, they go further steps. No grudges against one another. No losing temper. Even losing temper is not allowed. That is what Saint Paul says. No raising of one's voice at anyone. Why to raise voice? The voice is very nice. Why we have to shout and scream at the other and make him feel insecure because we are powerful? Third, words. My dear brothers and sisters, words are very, very powerful. Just think, in the last 24 hours, how many of our words were words of blessing? How many of our words were words of curses? How many of our words were words of grumbling against one another? No calling each other by names. We call everyone by names. In fact, this is a habit among all of us, to tease, to call by names, ragging, all these things goes on. We manipulate by our words. Words are very, very powerful. You say one powerful word of prayer for somebody who is sick today, and just see, in less than 24 hours, you will get a message. There is an improvement. He was not shaking his hands and legs, anything, and he started shaking his hand. And it will go on to an improvement. Words have power. Then the final recommendation which Saint Paul gives us through this Ephesians letter. Be friends to one another. Why to have enemies? I don't understand. In the life of Jesus, he didn't have enemies. All those who put him to the cross, he forgave them. All those who were trying to spit on him, hit him, put the crown, scourged him. He had nothing to say. Even to Pilate he said, if this authority was not given to you by my Father, you would have no more power. This is what he said. And therefore, final recommendation, be friends to all. Be kind and forgiving always, no matter whether they have done or I have done. Always forgiving and be kind. Going of oneself, giving of oneself as a fragrant offering, sacrifice to God our Father, as Jesus did. He was obedient, unto death, death on a cross. Therefore, God blessed him with the gift of resurrection. The third reading, we have been seeing this reading for many days, past few days, that Jesus says, I am the living bread who has come down from heaven. Therefore, if I am the living bread, Jesus is saying, anyone who eats, he has eternal life in me. All of us who are coming to churches, all of us who are experiencing the Lord, these days there is that we cannot go to churches, but we have already received Jesus so many times in our life, living bread. Let it have an effect now as you are reflecting Jesus, as we are reading the scriptures. Reflect and see that God really works wonders, Today, as we celebrate the Vianney Sunday, little information. I like this John Mary Vianney. When you go to ours, you find one child pointing a finger and showing him the way to the church. Very symbolically, he asked the child and the child showed him the way. It could be God who's come, angel who's come, who is showing him the way, and he goes because he is sent to the last and the remotest parish who people do not come to the church. What did John Mary Vianney do? First, he started praying. He was praying. Full time he was praying, and that prayer bore a fruit for people to come. One elderly lady came to see what he is doing, boiling potatoes and eating and praying the whole time. And slowly people started coming in and it started changing. This is how it changed. Secondly, he was so much into prayer, especially devotion to Mother Mary. So we learn devotion to Mother Mary from him. Third, he was, because of his devotion to Mother Mary and his prayer life, he became an instrument of God, a vessel of honor of God in confession to everyone, and his words were life-giving words. That's what many people started coming to us. As we are celebrating his feast, I conclude with one small incident. There was two priests in one diocese. They were on the island, cut off from all the world. And the bishop was going for a visitation. And the bishop took the boat and went across. He went to the island. He searched and he found them there, sitting and praying. And then the bishop was asking them, both the priests, the prayers. They had forgotten the prayers. And the island, nothing to do. Those people who are there, they are working with them. And bishop was trying to teach them the Our Father. That also they had forgotten. And after some time, bishop got tired and he said, let me go back. So he came to his boat, took the boat, and he was returning. So the priests, both the priests were reading that prayer which the bishop has given, and they were trying to memorize it, and they forgot one line. And they ran from the island straight on the water, straight to the middle of the sea, and they are asking him, what was the other line? The bishop looked, there is no need of other line. You go and you pray as you are praying. Prayer is so powerful. Let us, as we pray for our priests, let us pray for our families as well. God may gift us this gift of prayer, of living together, kind and forgiving and loving always. May Jesus' name be praised. God bless you. Please stand. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins,
the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
The prayer of the faithful. Dear friends, we have a high priest who is able to empathize with us in our weakness. Let us then, with confidence, ask him to provide us with the sustenance needed for our pilgrim journey as we sing.
Our response: Eternal High Priest, hear our prayer. Please repeat.
Eternal High Priest, hear our prayer.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and for his intentions this month, that God, who has given him to be the shepherd of our church, may bless him with good health and wisdom in leading his people. We pray in faith.
Eternal High Priest, hear our prayer.
For the church, that at this time of the pandemic, may help all the faithful to rekindle a greater love and deeper devotion to the Eucharistic Lord. We pray.
Eternal High Priest, hear our prayer.
For all priests who are called to feed the stock with the bread of life, that the Lord may sustain them in their ministry. We pray in faith.
Eternal High Priest, hear our prayer.
For those affected by the recent floods, that the relief measures underway may help them experience God's love and care in their time of need. We pray.
Eternal High Priest, hear our prayer.
For our intentions. We pray.
Eternal High Priest, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus Christ, true manna from heaven, hear and answer our prayers. Draw us to yourself and deepen our faith in the precious gift of yourself that you have given us. We ask this of you who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Love to a call.
pray that yours and my sacrifice may be acceptable to Lord, to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. By his birth, he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering cancelled out our sins, and by rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Sing Alleluia. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Sing Hosanna,
sing Hosanna,
sing Hosanna,
sing Hosanna,
sing Hosanna,
sing Hosanna,
sing Alleluia.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. together with Francis, our Pope, Oswald, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her blessed spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint John Bosco, Saint John Mary Vianney, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Please join me now in this act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart, as though you were already there. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Permit not that I should ever be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Let us go to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Stay.